Heart-filled wisdom that blooms out of conscience. December 24, 2014. Precious hearts, how is it, after all your efforts to accumulate and sometimes contemplate your experiences, that wisdom seems to elude many of you? You do comprehend that true wisdom is not something that can be instantly created or simply acquired. It is pretty relative that you open yourself to it through the purity of harmony of your personal power and will. You are aware that the ultimate source of wisdom lies in the divine kingdom, and from this mighty divine and heavenly Father you are encouraged to explore your inner self and discover your own inner wisdom, an intuition that every dear son and daughter of God does carry. It is your inner sensitive energy, a sort of perception that is often described as conscience, that at certain times reminds you of its presence. Precious hearts, how often do you think of conscience as being just something instilled to you by parents and teachers to be morally sensible? Well, conscience holds much more potential than reminding you of your manners and considerations towards others. It embraces the potential to extend you far beyond anything you may have been taught or even experienced. The information and knowledge learned as children of what is right, wrong, good or bad often dissolves before you begin to make a real contribution to life. Nonetheless, conscience that is based on wisdom from your heart will serve you well as a reliable moral compass in any circumstance. Understandably, knowing the difference from right, wrong, good or bad will not take you quite far enough. If you are to fulfill your highest potential, be of service to others, contribute creatively to life, marry and settle down, etc., then you realize that such a moral compass cannot provide you with all the answers to your many questions on how and where to direct your journey. Your conscience, or inner intuition, enables each of you to understand wisdom as needed to any personal or even professional circumstance you might find yourself in. That includes your own specific set of possibilities and opportunities. Yet, in order to hear your inner voice of conscience, you need to prepare yourself to be less selfish and egocentric, and serve unconditionally from the heart. Can you open and expand your conscience, and learn to differentiate between the voice of your intuition or conscience and the voice of your ego? Well, precious hearts, quite simply put, you must find a way that is gradual and gentle, that develops the intuition's sensitive energy that connects to your own perception and understanding of what is right. Many times it is the insecurity of your hearts and the clutter of your minds that present problems. Each of you are filled with so many urges and desires, so many thoughts fill your mind and fight for the spotlight of your attention, that for you to hear your inner voice of conscience amid all the chatter, distractions and temptations challenges your intuition and ability to discriminate between your voice of conscience and your ego's voice. But, there is hope, as there is always hope. With spiritual practice and exercise that is consistent, you can learn to quiet your mind to such a low tempo that its lack of noise pacifies your lovely heart, which supports and guides the imminent arrival of your conscience out from all the noise that was once there. Your conscience does see. It is able to witness your behavior, attitude, as well as your inner and outer actions, but from an objective standpoint. When your feelings, thoughts, words and actions fall and become rude and unbecoming, it is your conscience that sees the truth in all matters and often creates a feeling of embarrassment, knowing you have been seen by your inner self. And if your inner self can recognize what is going on, imagine what others can see. Many times, you think you have hidden everything about you from the world, but in fact your conscience sees all that you have tucked away. But if you have the courage to open this door of your inner self and see honestly and truthfully your egocentric behavior, it is your conscience that becomes your lifeline of hope that shows you a way out, a way of purification from the inside out, that will lead you to liberation from your controlling ego. Your higher self speaks to you through your intuition. It is how it sees you exactly as you are. It sees through the walls and masks you attempt to wear, and it is your intuition or conscience, if you like the term more, that directs you towards cleansing your inner self from all the impurities and discord that surrounds you. It is thanks to your conscience that you are able to see all the things you are emotionally attached to, and illuminates a path just for you so you can let them go. And when you let them go, you are making room for new, bright directions and attractions to take their place. Being open to your conscience, in additionally, means you are completely ready for any of its promptings. If you are not completely ready, your conscience will withdraw and go back to sleep. After consideration and contemplation, you feel your intuition is not going to disturb your beliefs or what you hold as value. You then can act on it. Hindsight offers a lot of learning that can be utilized next time you work with your intuition. It is a learning process, listening to your deepest and innermost voice, which is not perfected overnight, but by steadily honing into your conscience and allowing it to gradually bloom, you will learn to discern the voice of truth that is within all of you. Quite simply put, your conscience is nothing less than your truest self, and listening to this inner truth and following its direction, knowing of its connection to the divine and of the Father that bestowed this gift to every son and daughter, is up to you to hone and develop. If you were to follow more often your unique conscience, you would understand yourself at an intimate level, and over time become your true self in all areas at all times. Of course, this will not be an easy path because of the many conflicts your conscience faces when you bring desire and wants into the picture. On the path to liberating yourself from your ego, you will face many choices, and sometimes, precious hearts, the choices may be terribly difficult, as they will be asking you to let go what you are unable to choose because you are making a different choice. If you are given two choices, only one can be truly accepted, the other must be let go. It is important, dear ones, to unburden yourself from egocentric and emotional attachments. The sooner you are able to do this, the more liberated and open you will become. If you can accept the promptings of your conscience, it will be able to guide you through any life difficulty or event. When you live in conscience, you are basically giving God, your Heavenly Father, an open invitation to see everything you do internally and externally. Developing your conscience will open up so many new directions, but most of all, it will open your true self, the self that many dear souls have pushed aside. Be present, be yourself, and shine, precious hearts, and shine like the beautiful soul that you are, for it is your soul that we see above anything else. I am Archangel Jophiel through Julie Miller. SpiritualNetworks.com